Welcome to this video about eco-design. Sustainability can be very complex and it can be hard to figure out how and where to start. After this video, you will know how sustainability can fit into the design process of an engineering project. You will learn what methods are available to decide which ones are suitable for your project and how to implement them. Let's start with an overview. Chances are you're already familiar with this design cycle. Our goal is to show you how and when you can include sustainability into your design process. For each step, the goal will be mentioned and then we will address how sustainability can be taken into account. It is up to you to choose which methods suit your product best and to which extent you will use them. All the methods used in this video are treated in the Sustainable Mechanical Engineering Guide and the two lectures given by Green & Me. Those can be found by going to the website or scanning the QR code. You can use these references if you wish to find out more about the topics discussed in this video. Now let's begin. The first phase is called the Explore and Analyze assignment phase. Here you will set up your sustainability requirements. When doing so, make sure to be precise and specific. Just like with all your other requirements, it is necessary that they can be validated. The requirement having a low impact would, for example, be too vague. The next steps will make it more specific. First of all, define what impact you're talking about. This could be, for example, water usage, toxic emission, or CO2 footprint. Secondly, specify what phases of the design cycle you're looking into. Are you analyzing the full life cycle or only the impact in the processing phase? And last but not least, make it measurable so that it can be validated. With these steps, we could, for example, get the following requirements. Having a 30% CO2 footprint reduction in the processing phase and manufacturing phase compared to the original product. This is compared to the previous one, a proper requirement we can design for and which can be assessed. Keep in mind that many other requirements could be thought of. And in the case of sustainability requirements, it is usually good to have more than one. After the requirements are defined, we continue to the next phase, the create and collect solutions phase. Here you will look into design directions and solutions for meeting your newly set requirements. There are many ways to do this, one of which is the well-known morphological analysis. The second method is called the eco-design strategy wheel. This method gives advice per phase on how to reduce impact. Keep in mind that other methods, like bio-inspired design, are also possible. In the next conceptual design phase, multiple concepts have to be developed, after which they are evaluated and selected. Your goal is to make a quick estimate of the concepts, leading to a rough but substantiated comparison based on your chosen requirements. Criteria matrices, such as shown on the slide, are often used to compare and select concepts. The scoring of the concepts based on your sustainability criteria should be quick, because it's the concept phase, but still substantiated. This could be hard and therefore the following assessment of method and tool are introduced to help you do this. The method is called the MET matrix and will help you gain insight into the impact of your concepts. This method can be used both quantitative and qualitative, but the latter is more common for this phase. This matrix shows the phases of the life cycle of a product on the left column and the different aspects on which the products have influence on the environment on the top row. Materials, energy usage, and toxic emissions. Use the matrix in the way which is meaningful to you. If your criterion was about material usage, you only need to use that column. If your criterion was about the production phase, you will only have to use that row. Do this for each concept and compare the results in your criteria matrix. This method is even more powerful when reliable data is used to substantiate the results. The software package Cambridge Engineering Selector, for some of you better known as CES-EDPAC, could be used as source. In the eco-design and sustainability databases of this software package, a lot of sustainable-related data can be found. This data, or a combination of data, can be plotted to compare materials. This example shows the CO2 footprint in the production phase plotted against the density of the materials. Use the raw data and the graphs to judge and compare your concepts. In the embodiment phase, the selected concept will be improved and the final design will be created. The goal during this phase is to design in a sustainable manner. The Sustainable Mechanical Engineering Guide contains a selection of the many design for tools available to help you achieve this. The first one is minimizing resource consumption, where you look into using the least amount of materials with lower impact. The second one is design for disassembly, where you design in such a way that the product is easy to disassemble. And the last tool is the lifetime optimization method. This method provides several ways in which your product can be optimized, from designing for an appropriate lifespan to designing for upgrading, maintenance, or reuse. Use the guide to find more information on their benefits and on how to use these methods. Now that we have the design, the first prototype can be created. During this phase, it could be tested whether the chosen design for a tool succeeded. However, a more precise analysis happens in the next phase. In the analyze results phase, you will dive deeper into the absolute assessment and you will check whether the requirements are fulfilled with the help of the assessment of tools. In contrast to the concept phase, you now need to make a more elaborate and precise estimate of the impact of your product. In this phase, the MET matrix can still be used, only this time it should be executed for the full design and more precise. A more profound and well-known method for assessment is called the fast-track lifecycle analysis, which can be done with the help of the EcoAudit tool of SES. The EcoAudit tool will ask you for specific data about your product's material usage, transport and use. After this is filled in, you can easily generate a chart or a report by clicking on the buttons at the end of the page, which will give you results similar to the ones shown on the slide. A great benefit of this tool is that you do not have to look up individual data about your materials yourself, since the program will automatically do that for you. To get more information on this tool, it is advised to watch the second lecture. Even though the results are a rough estimation of reality, the tool is still very useful to get insight into the impact of each component and each part of the life cycle. The results you get from the analyze result phase can now be compared with the requirements from step one. When they are not met or further improvements can be made, we continue to the next phase, the iteration phase. Here you can use the information from the previous phase to apply improvements to your product's design. Ideas for solutions can be thought of in several ways. One method to get ideas and possible improvements is by means of the compare tool of the EcoAudit. With this, you can make a change in a specific aspect of the design and quickly check how big the influence is. When making improvements in a certain phase of the lifecycle, it can happen that this has negative consequences for other stages. For example, if you choose to use less material, there's a chance that the lifetime of your product will be lower. Always be careful for these consequences. When the iteration phase was successful and the analyze result phase showed that the product met your requirements, you successfully implemented sustainability into your engineering project. Well done! This was a short explanation on how you can take sustainability into account in your design process. We hope you have learned how to make sustainability specific and how to successfully implement it in each step of your design process. Use the methods that are most suited for you and your project in the time available. And use the sources in this video to look up more information on specific topics when needed. Thanks a lot for your attention.